All right, it's day two of rehearsals, and we have plenty to do today. Cyprus, Norway, Croatia are up as we speak, and we have five other countries that we get to throughout the day. It'll be very busy time. We're going to start with Cyprus, though. They just had their rehearsal. El Diablo is the song, and we shall see what kind of sorcery the devil's gotten into. Another damn. If this video will play, here we go. Let's see. I love the interpretation of the devil theme, like the red latex, like dancer backgrounds. Without making it like, obviously costumey. It just stays like it really, really pops. That's a big thing that really like pops out to me is just that there's so much, there's a lot of contrast here. Alright, we'll get Norway up soon. We just got the snippet from Norway, Texas Fallen Angel. And we kind of have a good idea of what they're going to go for. Like they did a lot of similarities to Melody Grand Prix. But then again, we should see, in fact, what they did end up changing. I don't know how I feel about the sparkles instead of what we had at Melody Grand Prix. Of course the wings are there still. I hope it seems the lighting effects. Like the lighting particularly with the backdrop is really, really nice. The photos Evie put out. I do think it's just like costumey though compared to... We have Over the Apple before, the very slick polish or the like... pop girly sort of staging, for lack of a better term, and then we have Tix more or less tackling the same sort of vibe in a very costume way. I don't know if it's a bad thing for Tix, but it's definitely interesting to have them like run after the other. Croatia's next, and then we'll have Belgium before the break. Albina just finished her rehearsal for Croatia for TikTok. And this is one of the stages I'm most excited of so far today. There's a really cool effect that I hope we get to see here, but I don't know if it will. I'll be watching the video for the first time with you here, so I'll just stop yapping and we can get into it. I love this like neon, like blue pink color scheme we got in and out of the final, and the fact that they kept it here is just amazing. And I'm going to be like banged it vocally, like this has all the makings of being one of the standpoints of the night. They didn't show that effect, but they basically, I obviously put it, but they basically have put the person in the pressure of people who are seeing the full version of all of these performances live-ish as it's happening. There's like five, they basically, it's not like a hologram thing, like so like five separate clones of Albina during the performance at some point. So hopefully get to see some of that in the second rehearsal, because that... I'm very interested in seeing how that comes together. Anyways, I'm going to end this clip and then record the Hoopa Fines react, because that's also here. That's the Hoopa Fines, like, the big dark horse of the semi. Like, you have all of these bops, this is the one sort of intimate, like, down tempo, obviously, like, song. I don't know how I feel about the eyes. I like it in the wider shots they show, like in the fifth flash shot. I don't know how it feels if we get like a tight shot, like the screen in the background. But I do love this sort of intimate, like dark, broody sort of staging to give like that creepy, intimate vibe. Like it feels like a Calm Out of the Storm sort of moment to get here. Alright, that's it for the first half of today's rehearsals. We have Israel, Romania, Azerbaijan coming up. Lots of stuff to come. Eden just finished her rehearsal of Set Me Free. Let's take a look. A sneak peek. It would be nice if I hit the right thing. Here. I ignored you for a long, long time. The one thing I'll say is that this I backed up, let's take a bit, because I love the like, style, but this LED background is doing a lot. Big note, the big whistle note. You're in the wrong place. Yep. I can't tell if that was live or from the studio version, but at least the version we got. But she, according to everything we've heard from the press room, even the official Eurovision account tweeted about it, she hit it four times in rehearsal, so definitely going to be one to watch going into the rest of. I guess the first semifinal, I should say. Roxy from Romania is back with a look at Amnesia. I mean, the staged concept is one, this is what I'm personally invested in, because like, it's a song that's like, grabbed me from the very beginning in terms of just the overall sort of vibe of the song and the message it's trying to tell. And the music video especially is really, really cool in how it tells that story, so I'm hoping that we get some of that influence into the actual live stage show. Only time can find out. So we shall watch the video and see. Hello. What we're looking at. Some people criticize the hoodie. Obviously I like it, it really fits in with the rock and roll aesthetic. And the vibe of the song. These shots are gorgeous. Vocal could be better. But I don't think it's like egregiously bad. Like it's definitely serviceable and I feel like as you get like more and more dressed person, then hopefully it'll start to improve a bit. Overall, like I'm happy that it's more or less a music video concept just amplified for the right damn stage. Okay, we're getting added by John's rehearsal now. Matahari, the song. On this one, what I'm most concerned about, because in the live performance we've seen, Fendi hadn't exactly had the best, shall we say, live performance, at least of anyone we've seen in the competition, and it's such an up-tempo song that needs to have a solid performance to really stand much of a chance, and it's such a strong semi, of course, the stage it could pretty much be the difference between qualifying and not qualifying. Anyways, I'll stop babbling, let's just dive into it and see what we've got. Bring yourself down. You're not alone, not alone now. At least a bit stiff, I think, maybe. I love the backing, I love the backdrop, but I feel like there needs to be something more. Like, apparently there was no pyro in the performance, and I feel like pyro was like the one thing that this performance needs to really have more of an edge, especially this dance, like, you know, like, if it got pyro in that second, that could have been something. Two more performances to go today, we have Ukraine, Malta. I'm excited. Let's keep the good vibes going. Okay, we have the final two rehearsal clips of the day. Of this first semifinal, actually, we're going to start with Ukraine. It has gotten a ton of hype from the press photos alone. But let's see it in action. This is going to be my first time watching it along with you. And then there's Malta, Jay McCass. Honestly, I have a lot going into this personally. I mean, it's my winner, my stand country. Please don't mess it up. I love the loud colors. Like, it's deep. Like, this is a song that is definitely needs to pop. Like, in neon, you can always count on you in the pop. Of course, Stephanie giving everything over to me. The one thing we knew going into was that this musical was going to be on point. Kind of getting like dance off vibes with the backdrop. You can kind of see like the rain shower, golden shower. I wonder how that looks. I obviously don't know when they use it, but like that, I feel like that could really work as like a closure to the whole thing, like to go really that retro swing vibe. And that's it for the first semifinal. Let's see who I think is at least. Let's see who I think is the best of the day, who's the worst in the day, right now.